want to. But when God gives you over and gives you a strong delusion to where you will believe a lie, it's too late.
Too late. Amen.
Amen. Nothing we can do. Nothing we can say.
Nope.
You're in the hands of God.
Jesus.
Having eyes.
Jesus.
That they should not see. Having ears. Mm-hmm. That they should not hear. Mm-hmm. Until this day.
Day. That's right.
Oh, praise the name of our God.
Right now.
Right now, no matter how much we go to those individuals that are Jewish believers, they will not receive that Jesus Christ is the Messiah.
No, they won't.
Because their eyes have been blinded.
My Lord.
Their ears have been closed up. They've become dull of hearing. And the word of the Lord said, what, brother?
I say then.
Verse number 9.
And David said.
And David said.
Let their table be made a snare.
Let their table be made a snare.
And a trap.
And a trap.
And a stumbling block.
And a stumbling block.
And a recompense unto them.
And a recompense unto them. You know where what the purpose of a table is? Sit down and eat and be merry.
Mm-hmm.
Sit down and indulge themselves. He said, let their table be made a snare unto them and a trap. A place where they should be being fed the word of God has now become a snare unto them.
Maybe
that all you ones that's trying to run away from the truth suddenly.
Come on.
Let me warn you, the table that you sit at to eat going to be a snare unto you.
Amen.
And it's going to be a trap and a stumbling block.
Amen.
You're going to find yourself in the lake of fire.
Amen.
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 As you know, folks nowadays got itching ears.
Yep.
And they want their fancy to be tickled.
Mm-hmm.
Praise the name of our God. They're running after teachers who are going to feed them what they want to hear.
That's
but
right.
The fact of the matter is, no matter where you go, what you need to do is repent.
That's right. Amen.
Talk back to them.
Amen.
Repentance is the only thing that's going to clean the church up.
The only thing.
You got to repent.
Got to.
We can't preach enough of repentance. We got to preach repentance today as we see that day coming.
That's
everybody got to repent.
That's right. Amen.
You got to repent.
That's
right. You got to feel sorry about your ways.
That's right.
You got to feel sorry about your wrongdoing.
Right.
You got to look at God and say, Father, I repent.
Got to.
In order that God might clean you up.
Right.
Folks in the church today just don't want to repent.
No. Nope. Playing with God.
Don't want to repent.
Playing.
Don't want to turn away from.
That's right.
And repenting is just not saying, Lord, I'm sorry.
Nope.
Oh, forgive me. Repentance means you got to do a total 360.
Right. Turn
away. If you walk in one direction, you got to do a total about face and go in the opposite direction.
That's right.
But the problem is, folk don't want to give up.
Nope.
Don't want to cut off. Don't want to let go. But the fact of the matter is, whatever you hold it on to will be the death of you.
Yes, sir.
Praise the name of our
yes,
God.
Yes, sir.
There's something that you got to let go.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
You got to repent of it. Turn away from it.
And soon.
Moses said, I would rather suffer with the people of God than enjoy the presence of sin but for a moment. Because it's only a moment.
That's all it is.
Amen. It's only a moment. That no high is only a moment. And when you get high, you're coming back down.
Coming right back down.
It's only a moment.
Just a moment.
Praise the name of our God. That no sex might feel good for the moment.
Right. Tell the truth.
But when you're done, that void is still there.
Right there.
Praise the name of our God.
Right.
When everything is done, it's still there.
Amen.
You can sleep with as many women as you want to.
Right.
But after you finish going through every last one of them, when the dust settles, the void is still there.
Right there.
Glory to the Lamb.
Amen.
And the only thing that can fill that void is Jesus Christ.
Thank you, Lord.
He's the only one.
Thank you, Lord.
That can fill
thank
every
you, Jesus.
Boy that every last one of us got.
Thank you, Lord.
That's why we're running from this place
yep.
to that place.
That's
I'm
right.
satisfied.
That's right.
Praise the name of
tell
the Lord.
Tell the truth.
Because there's only one that can satisfy.
Only
amen.
One.
Amen. He said he will be the desire of men. There's one that we all should desire, and that is Jesus the Christ.
That's him.
Amen.
That's him.
After the dust settled, it all clear. You still gonna be running after whatever it is you're running after.
Because
you're searching for something, but you're searching in the wrong places.
Come on.
Death of you, my Lord. My Lord.
Everywhere you turn, wonder why. Every time you turn around, it seems like you're going through the same
yep.
thing.
Yeah.
You're like a dog chasing his own tail. You're never gonna get it.
Nope.
Amen. And you're just gonna spend your time running around in circles. Wonder why it ain't working for me. And wonder why I ain't been delivered. Wonder why I can't break through. Because you're like a dog chasing his own tail.
Jesus.
Amen.
My Lord.
You know what? You're chasing after yourself. That's what the Bible said. Don't be self-willed. And we got a lot of self-willed folk in the house of God.
Amen.
Want to do things your way.
Yep.
Got to have it your
that's
way.
Right.
If it ain't my way, it's no way. But you got to lose your way
yes.
and humble yourself.
Yeah.
Right
there.
Amen. Amen.
It's the truth.
Too many self-willed people in the
my
house
Lord.
Of God. Amen. 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 Self-will. God ain't never asked you nothing about your opinion.
My Lord.
Amen.
Folks looked at Jesus and heard Peter preaching on the day of Pentecost as he talked about the man Christ Jesus. He said, let the house of Israel know assuredly.
Mm.
That God have made that same Jesus
same
whom
you
crucified, both Lord and
same
Christ.
Jesus.
They looked at him and said, men and brethren, what shall we do? Peter didn't say, well, what you think you should do? He didn't ask you your
true.
Opinion or your thought about it. He said, repent.
Amen. Right.
And be baptized.
That's
every
right.
one of you in the name of Jesus Christ, away with what you think.
Amen.
Amen.
The yes, only sir. Formula. My Lord.
He asked you, what you think you should do?
Amen.
How you feel about it? And,
yes,
you know, well, after I told you that, what you think about it? He didn't ask nobody's opinion.
Repent.
He told you what you had to do. Repent.
Jesus.
And that's the only thing that's going to get us into the kingdom of God.
The only thing.
You got to repent.
Got to.
Praise the name of our God. Let's finish this up, brother.
Now,
verse number 10.
Let their eyes be dark.
Let their eyes be darkened.
That they may not see.
That they may not see.
And bow down their back always.
That they may bow down their back always.
I say then.
God has darkened the eyes of so many people in the church.
Yeah.
It has become a sad reality.
Yes, sir.
That so many people are groping in the darkness.
Yes, sir.
God has darkened their eyes. That's why they're walking and they're walking into walls.
My Lord.
Walking into pews. Walking into a whole bunch of stuff because a blind person can't see.
That's right.
Amen. That blind person don't know what's there in front of him. If you don't tell him, sister, be careful. Brother, go this way. If you don't lead him and direct him, you're going to run right into destruction. So the Bible says there's a way that seemeth right unto a man.
Yeah.
But the end thereof is death.
Death.
The end thereof is destruction. And the end thereof is shipwreck.
Amen.
Oh, my Lord.
Blinded. Your eyes have been darkened. Some folk that profess to have the Holy Ghost, eyes have been darkened.
Yes,
the
sir.
Light have went out.
Yes, sir.
Praise the name of our God.
Amen.
You once were able to see, but you let people and things cloud your vision.
That's
and
right.
God has darkened your amen. Understanding.
Amen.
Praise the name of our God. And now you're walking and groping in darkness.
Amen.
Amen.
My Lord.
You know how some of the reason why some of y'all can't see is because the Bible said, who takes the light and put it underneath a bushel? See, some of y'all was ashamed of the gospel.
Uh-huh.
Amen.
Come on, preacher.
Ashamed of the gospel. And so when you got the light, you didn't go put it on the lampstand. You wouldn't go hid it. Every time you go to your unsaved loved one house and
come
you're
on.
Doing what they're doing and not
amen.
Letting the light shine, you're hiding it.
Amen.
And the light is dimming out.
Amen.
In the name of our God.
That's
amen.
Right.
If you smother the light, the only thing that it's going to do is go out.
That's right.
And when the light go out, you're going to be walking around in darkness.
In darkness. Amen.
Amen. Some of y'all going over unseen loved ones' houses, mm-hmm. having conversation with unsaved people, mm-hmm. and the little bit of light that you do got has been smothered right. and suffocated.
Amen.
Because your conversation jacked up. The Bible said evil communication,
right.
corrupt
that's
good manners. Manners. Everything you learn in here,
that's
you
right.
lose when you go out
Amen.
There and start talking to the wrong people.
Amen. Amen.
Evil communication, corrupt good manners.
That's
you got
right.
to be careful who you talk to, even in the house of God.
Amen.
Amen.
Yes, sir.
Some people in the house of God, you ought to say, praise the Lord. No, matter of fact, some folk, you just need to say, how you doing, brother?
Keep
how
it,
you doing,
keep
sister?
It real.
And keep walking.
That's right.
Amen.
Lord
said, don't even bid them God's
That's
speak.
Right.
Some folk, you shouldn't even bid God's
no,
speak
sir.
Or pronounce blessings of God upon. You
no,
should say,
sir.
How you doing, brother?
That's the truth.
Amen. Evil communication, corrupt good manners.
Yes, sir.
Some folk right in the house of God that didn't used to talk to one another now become buddy buddy in order that they can
yes.
come together and have the first conversation.
Yes, yes.
Come back to
yes.
Come on.
Amen.
Some of y'all communicate with folk that no longer go here.
That's
that's
right.
talking evil against the church.
Amen.
Hypocrites.
Amen.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
And you think the man of God don't know? What you still keep in communication with them for, and they're not here. If you're not there to reconcile that brother or sister
That's
back
right.
to Christ, stop talking to them.
Amen.
Praise Amen. The name of God.
Amen.
I'm telling you, I got your number too. Amen.
Come
Some
on.
Folk running the household, pounding the church, talking against the pastor, all that type of foolishness.
My Lord.
Some folk that's striving, hypocrite,
Amen.
And every idle word. Don't come before you in judgment. But I'm telling y'all something. God is cleaning the house.
Yes, he is.
There's a proof that God has taken to the house. And I heard on the first, they
yes.
spit out the trash.
Yes.
Let me tell y'all something.
Oh,
when
my Lord.
God,
hey. Good Jesus.
I'm tell y'all something.
Come on, preacher.
If me and Elder First ain't twins in the spirit,
oh,
I don't
my
know
Lord.
What we are.
Jesus.
My wife on the past couple of weeks
Jesus.
Have been praying nothing but Elder First's message.
Jesus.
And I'm sitting there saying, my God,
yes.
everything the man talked about, I'm still dealing with
yes.
today. When are you
yes.
going to repent?
Yes. Amen.
That man preached the same thing
yes.
for 15 years. And
yes.
I'm coming here and some of y'all still doing
yes.
the same stuff. Y'all ain't hear nothing new. Some of you ones sitting there nodding your head was the ones he was talking to.
That's
and
right.
you still ain't repented.
Amen.
You're the same hypocrisy when he was alive and still ain't repented yet.
Jesus, Jesus.
But I'm telling you, God got your number.
Yes,
there's
sir.
A damn reckoning coming and you gonna stand before God.
Jesus, my Lord.
Praise the name of God.
My Lord.
Same ones.
Amen.
Even his children, grandchildren,
my Lord.
The same gospel
yes.
you have heard it for years. Some of you are saying amen to it.
That's
and
right.
it still ain't changed yet.
That's
when
right.
are you going to repent?
That's right. Come on, preacher.
Let me tell you something. When God shoots, God don't shoot no blanks. He hit right at the target.
That's right.
God don't shoot sparingly. He shoot to kill. And there's some stuff in you that the
Jesus.
Man of God been shooting.
Jesus.
By the Spirit of God, and you still ain't got
Jesus.
It together yet.
Jesus. Jesus.
That's why some of y'all quiet.
That's right.
Amen. You know when you know when it hit them, they sit there quiet.
Uh-huh.
Amen.
Come on, let God use you, brother.
No more is hitting because they sit there, claim to have the Holy Ghost and can't say amen.
That's
God
right.
is hitting you. And
amen.
God is hitting you. Because
yes.
remember you're real.
Hallelujah!
Amen. God ain't playing with his church.
Speak, Lord.
To get right, or you gonna get left.
Speak, Lord.
Yes.
Speak, Lord. Hallelujah!
I've heard that man laboring. And when I first got here, refuse to listen to him in order that my mind wouldn't be clouded.
Jesus.
And now that we're going back and listening, I hear stuff that brother preached at almost verbatim.
Yes.
He said word for word the same thing.
Yes.
Amen. Word for word. Amen. My wife come home one day after she went to work listening to him. And I get in the car, cut the radio on, boom, that thing blasted. She turned that thing up full volume.
Thank you, Lord.
Full volume.
That's right.
Getting the car, she started telling me everything the minister said. She said, Mama, do you not know some of the stuff you've been saying on the floor? Elder first said in this city.
That's right. Amen.
I'm sitting there with my Lord.
Same stuff.
Same stuff. Same stuff I'm seeing among so-called saints of God now. He was preaching against.
Yes.
And you didn't hear him. So you ain't going to hear me.
No, sir.
Because you're blinded.
That's right.
And your ears have been clogged up.
Amen.
And you're spiritually deaf.
That's right.
And you keep being that way. The only thing that's left for you is the lake of fire.
Lake of fire.
But God will always send a warning to his people to get right with God and do it now.
Yes. Yes. Hang with God.
Same stuff.
My Lord.
Yes.
Jesus.
I thank God that God did it the way he did it. I didn't know that man in the flesh. He didn't know me in the flesh.
Mm-hmm.
But you know what? God had us tied up and tangled up in the spirit.
Yes.
And we didn't even know one another.
That's right.
My Lord Jesus.
Right in the spirit.
Amen.
That's why I see why the word of God said, no man after the flesh, but after the spirit.
That's right.
When you're together in the spirit, you're going to speak the same thing.
Amen.
And never hear one another.
Amen.
Amen. And I get here, some of y'all start acting like, oh, he bringing in new doctrine. No, I'm not either. He was saying it before I got here.
Amen. That's right.
Amen.
Amen.
Saying the same thing, but you just wasn't listening.
Thank you, Jesus.
Amen. See, but you better get into this word and realize that what he said in this book, what happened to the natural children of Israel, is going to happen to you that claim you're in the church.
That's
if
right.
You don't straighten up and repent.
Amen. And soon.
Let's go, brother.
My Lord.
This is some good stuff.
Yes,
you
it is.
At the table, the same word you hearing is going to be a stumbling block for you.
Lord have mercy.
It's going to be a snare for you. It's going to be a trap for you.
My Lord.
What good is it to hear all this word for all these years
and lose your salvation?
That same word is what's going to judge you in the end.
Amen.
Jesus said, I judge no man, but there's one that judges the word that's been preached to you for these past 40 something years is going to be your judge. That's and Jesus Christ is going to sit there and going to say, did you obey it? No, to the lake you go.
My Lord.
My Lord. That word is going to do the judge. That's that same word you don't want to obey.
That's right. Same word.
Same word that you hear and don't want to do is going to judge you.
That's right.
So if you better do all you can to be obedient to the word of God.
Amen.
It's going to judge you.
Time is running out. My Lord.
It's going to judge you. You're going to stand before God and the book's going to be open. And then there's going to be another little book that's going to be open called the Book of Life. The dead that died under the old covenant going to be judged out of them other books. But there's a book that you and I are going to be judged out of called the Book of Life. And guess what he's going to do? He's going to open the book and he's going to look down the list of names and see if your name is written. If your name's not written, to the lake of fire you go.
Amen.
See, let me tell y'all something. Y'all are standing in judgment right now.
Amen. That's right. Right now.
Amen. Scripture said judgment starts in the house of God.
That's right.
Why preachers don't want to preach like this.
Amen.
I've got to preach like
got
this.
You.
Because right now I stand and God stand as your judge.
Amen.
If you won't listen to me, God will not hear you.
Amen.
Every preacher that preaches the truth of God, we stand in God's stand right now warning the people to get right with God. If you don't hear the preachers of the gospel, your soul is going to be lost.
Amen.
You ain't going to be able to stand before God and say, but.
Amen.
Amen.
My Lord.
Jesus.
Ain't none of that gonna be there. But look, you know I know, you know my heart.
Yes, he does.
Let me tell y'all something. Let me tell you how tight God got this thing. He said every secret thing.
My Lord.
You know that stuff y'all trying to hide?
Yep. That ain't hidden.
Every secret thing.
That's right.
Every secret communication. Every secret thought that you're pondering in your heart. I might not can hear. Your brother might not can hear. Your sister might not can hear. But don't you know Paul hears it?
Yes, he does.
That
yes,
God's
he does.
Keeping a record of it.
Yes,
it you know how that little typist sit there in the courtroom.
Yeah. Court stenographer.
He and she sitting right there typing every word that's being said.
That's right.
The Bible and the scripture call them scribes. Amen. They were walking around with notebooks recording everything they see. Y'all know that God is sitting there and taking record, the angels of heaven taking record of everything you say, everything that you're doing, and he got a whole laundry list of it. And you can't hide nothing from God.
Nothing.
But God, I didn't say you might can lie to the preacher, but you can't lie to God.
That's right. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Jesus.
You can't lie to God. God seeing everything you're doing.
My Lord.
And everything that's transpiring.
Yes.
And he said every idle word. Gonna be before you in judgment. He gonna let every word you say come back before you in plain daylight, like a screen.
Yeah.
And you know how he gonna do it? He gonna do it just like the little text messages you got.
Mm-hmm.
He gonna let it come up in text message form so you can read it for yourself.
Yeah.
And you ain't gonna be able to stand in front of God and say, I didn't say it. How you gonna lie to God?
That's right.
See, because after you say it, I didn't say it, what he gonna do? He gonna unveil the video.
That's right.
And he gonna show you on that phone call.
That's
show
right.
you when you were sitting at that table. He gonna show you when you pondered it in your heart and let you hear what he heard.
Amen.
You can't hide from God.
Can't deny it.
Amen.
My Lord.
Amen. Let's go, brother.
I say then. Have they stumbled? That they should fall.
God forbid.
But rather through their fall.
Through the natural children of Israel's fall.
Salvation has come.
Unto the Gentiles.
Yeah. For to provoke them to jealousy.
To provoke them to jealousy.
Now if the fall of them. Be the riches of the world. And the diminishing of them. The riches of the Gentiles. How much more then.
Their fullness.
For I speak to you, Gentiles. And as much as I am an apostle of the Gentiles. I magnify my office. If by any means. I may provoke to emulation. Them that are my flesh. And might save some of them. For if the casting away of them. Be the reconciling of the world. What shall the receiving of them be? But life from the dead. For if the first fruit be holy.
The lump is also holy.
That's right.
And if the root be holy.
So are the branches.
Thank you, Jesus.
And if some of the branches be broken off.
And now.
Being a wild olive tree. Were grafted in among them.
My Lord. And with them.
Partaketh of the root. And fatness of the olive tree. Boast not against the branches. But if thou boast. Thou bearest not the root.
My Lord.
But the root thee.
My Lord.
Thou wilt say then. The branches were broken off. That I might be grafted in. Well. Because of unbelief.
My Lord.
They were broken off.
That's right.
And thou standest by faith. Be not high-minded.
He talking to the church?
Yes, he is.
be not high-minded
to Jesus,
but fear.
For if God spare not the natural,
we read that again. I think some folk need to hear.
My Lord,
well,
because of unbelief, they were broken off, and now standeth by faith.
They standeth by faith.
Be not high-minded.
Don't church.
Uh-huh.
Do not be high-minded.
Yes, sir.
Your hat, your skirt, your no makeup, your no jewelry is not what's getting you into
the
kingdom of God.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Let me say it again.
Amen. Come on,
your
preacher.
Your hat, your skirt, your no makeup, your no jewelry is not getting you into the kingdom of God.
Amen.
By grace are ye saved.
Amen. Through Jesus.
Yes, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
You got the nerve to be high-minded.
Mm-hmm.
Lord.
Arrogant in the house of God.
Yes, sir.
If the natural branches were cut off, what you think will happen to you?
Right.
Talk back to me.
That's right.
Church got it twisted.
Yes,
the
they do.
Pastor started holding his church. Got it twisted.
Come on, preacher.
Got it.
Got it twisted. And you got it twisted up something serious, too.
Amen.
Nothing you can do can gain you salvation.
That's right.
Salvation comes only through Jesus Christ. After you receive salvation, you do the things that accompany salvation.
Amen.
That's when you have your jewelry and all that stuff.
Amen.
But salvation is by grace alone.
Amen.
Grace alone. Now, how do we have the audacity to be high-minded?
That's right.
You see, some of y'all putting on hats and skirts and still hypocrite in your heart.
Tell the truth.
Amen.
Amen.
Some of y'all need to come in here looking like how your heart is.
Tell the truth. Amen. That's right.
Amen. Amen. I told you when I first got here, I much rather you come in here with your head uncovered, with your pants on, and say, look, I'm struggling, I'm a sinner, than to come in here looking like you sanctified and you're dirty.
Amen.
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 In the church for too long, know how to dress folks up, but your dress ain't getting you into the kingdom of God.
No, sir.
Amen. And that's why when newcomers come in the house of God, they're easily deceived by your appearance and don't know that nasty heart of yours.
Amen. Amen.
Amen.
That's right.
That's why I don't mind warning people either. Stay away from them.
Amen.
I'm gonna tell them to.
Yes, sir.
Right. Amen.
Amen.
But I'm sure I'm gonna tell every newcomer, if you don't get yourself together, I got a list of who to stay away from.
Amen. That's right, preacher.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
I got a list of who to stay away from.
Amen.
Don't talk to them. Say, peace be, praise Lord, and go about your business.
That's right. Tell the truth.
Amen.
Amen.
It's the reality of it. If some folks start getting entangled in you, their soul will be lost, and I'm a watchman on the wall. And if I don't cry out and spare not, the blood gonna be on my hands.
That's right.
Amen.
That's right.
And that's just the reality of it.
Amen.
Some folk you cannot intertwine with in the church. Everybody in the building's not in the body.
Amen.
I know they look sanctified.
Come on now.
Amen.
Amen.
They look sanctified. You know what our outward appearance is? It's like the natural circumcision. You know what they had to do on the eighth day? They had to take every male child and circumcise him. Cut the foreskin of his flesh. Amen. And that's how you knew he was a Jew, by the circumcision. But Paul came and upbraided us on that. He said a Jew is not one that is one outwardly, but one that's inwardly. It goes for the same thing. One who's one outwardly, but one that is one inwardly.
Amen.
You can look sanctified all day long, but if you don't got sanctification in the inward part, you're nothing.
Amen.
Amen. You just got a preacher that's bold enough to tell you that.
Thank you, Lord.